And your hubby too. How y'all living, fam? It is Saturday up in this motherfucker, and these motherfuckers right here, although Juice ain't here to really say that shit right now because he is doing his morning ritual. We both have missed y'all these last few days. Y'all, I know it's been a few days since we've uploaded a vlog. I apologize for that, but I had to play a lot of catch up. Even from back when I was helping my mom and my dad, when my mom went to the hospital and all that shit, I still am playing some of that catch up. And anyway, so I took a few days to be able to do that. Regrouped as far as some other stuff is concerned, and I'll tell you guys about that in a minute. Nothing bad, but anyway, took a little bit of time to just get a little bit caught up on some things, and still have to do a little bit more catch up, but I'm in a better place right now as far as that's concerned, so we are good. Hopefully I'm knocking shit over. Hopefully you guys are having a great day, night, day, weekend, weekday, whatever, whenever y'all are watching this motherfucking vlog. How's everybody doing, y'all? Look, your girl is so happy. It's the fucking weekend, and it just so happens to be date night for us. So we are gonna go out tonight. We're gonna do something a little bit different. I'll wait for Juice, and then we'll tell you what's gonna go on. But we're gonna do something a little bit different tonight, and I'm really excited. I always get really excited about, one, anything having to do with food, because we are gonna go out to eat tonight, and I always look forward to that shit. And two, when we have something new to do, and I'm still trying to debate on one other thing, so we're gonna see. I gotta ask Juice if he's down for it or whatever. That being said, I am making my first meal of the day. And I should probably let y'all know the way that looks. Okay. I should probably let y'all know that I'm experimenting a little bit with my macros. You guys haven't heard me talk about my my meal plan in a while, because during the time that my mom and dad had all those issues going on, you guys know I was kind of lax with it. And even though I wasn't overeating, I was under eating. You know what I mean? Because there's days that I wasn't eating the total amount of calories that I typically am supposed to eat. And then there were days where I just, it might have eaten over it. You know what I'm saying? And so it just wasn't a good balance. That being said, I needed to take some time off, because you guys know I've been doing it for a long period of time. So I explained all that shit to you. And so anyway, I'm back in full effect with the macros. However, y'all knew that was coming. I am experimenting with my macros a bit, because I'm still trying to break a number on the scale. Not that I need, it's not about the weight. You guys know that, obviously, I've told you guys that when I did my measurements, there were some measurements that were bigger than others and bigger than they've ever been. As far as, like, you know, certain parts of my body, there's some that have come down a lot, and I'm also heavier than I was before when I first started Team Transformation, if you can believe it, but I'm definitely more physically fit. I'm much stronger and I look a lot better. And now, granted, I was physically smaller back then when I first started Team Transformation. Physically, you can probably tell if you go back to old videos, physically I was smaller. But as far as my muscle definition and probably my mass to fat ratio, or my muscle to fat ratio is definitely different from back then, okay? You guys know I'm doing a lot more strength. I'm eating a shit ton more calories than I was eating back then. I was on a different meal plan. Granted, it was a great meal plan, but this one allows me a lot more flexibility, which you guys know I love, hence why it's called flexible eating. So, that being said, I've been having some fun experimenting with my macros a little bit. What I'm gonna have Jessica do, and she happens to be out of town, which is why you guys haven't seen a vlog with her in a little bit, so you won't see her until next week. She's at a workout conference, y'all. I'm telling you, she knows her shit, okay? She's got several degrees in several different arenas in the health field, okay? And fitness is her life, literally. She lives it, breathes it, educates people on it, educates herself on it. It's awesome. But what I'm gonna do with Jess is I'm gonna have her give me a workout plan that I'm gonna pretty much stick to for the next 2-3 weeks. Of course, I'll be able to freestyle a few moves, and there's gonna be things that I do, like my squats and my sumo deadlifts, things that I don't wanna lose any of my strength on, because I've worked so hard to get to those levels of fitness to be able to sumo deadlift 175 pounds and all that kind of shit, right? So I'll still be able to do that, but she's gonna give me a workout plan to stick to for the next 2 or 3 weeks. I'm assuming maybe 2, okay? She's gonna do the same thing for Juice. And We're gonna just follow that for the next 2 weeks, come back, do measurements, and just kind of, you know, get ourselves on something more regimented as far as workouts concerned, because you guys know I freestyle all my workouts. So a lot of what you see is stuff that I will literally sit down and put together and write down and figure out before I go to the gym. Or if I haven't had time to figure out what I'm gonna do when I go to the gym, I physically will go to the gym and freestyle, which I love and I hate. It just depends on the days that I do it. Weekdays, I don't have as much time in the gym because I still need to come back here, make dinner, even if I pre-planned dinner, pre-cooked dinner, or we pick up dinner. I don't like coming back home really late because it fucks up our sleep patterns, as you guys already know. So I'm more limited with time during the week, so I don't like freestyling my workouts during the week. As of late though, I have been, and it's because I've been semi-bored. You guys know I have to have something to stimulate me at all fucking times. So that being said, she's gonna give me and Juice a workout plan. We're each gonna have our own individual workout plans that we're gonna stick to. I'm still gonna work out with Jess, of course, which is why I love working out with her, because she challenges me every time I go and makes me do things I wouldn't probably challenge myself to do or probably stay doing, if that makes sense. And we're gonna do that for a little while and do measurements and all that stuff. I promised y'all I'm gonna do a video of my measurements and my weight and all that kind of stuff, and that kind of thing. So that's what's gonna change. I know I mentioned the whole Noelle, the girl that's on Instagram that I follow, that I absolutely love her body and adore her workouts. I do still have that plan. I'm going to incorporate some of her moves in all of this as well. However, some of the stuff that she has on her plan, as I've looked further into the weeks, because I haven't really done it consistently yet, so I just waited for all the weeks to come out. And if you're not familiar with what I'm talking about, there's a girl on Instagram. Her name is Noelle Benipi, something like that. And she has like a little 21-day plan type of situation that she put out. Really inexpensive. It's awesome. It has videos of every single, you know, exercise if you need reference, et cetera, et cetera. I've mentioned it before. However, here's the thing with that. A lot of the moves I can't do yet because of this neck issue. So a lot of them, like half of that shit. Like some of it's on the flow, and I can alter them and change it up to suit, you know, the fact that I can't do certain things, certain movements with my neck yet. But I'd rather just wait to incorporate, like if I was to do her whole workout, I think I'd be hurting myself a little bit with this neck thing. So I'll be incorporating some of her moves within my workouts, but I'm gonna do it more so this way because Jess knows my ailment. And so what she's gonna plan for me is gonna be specific to the fact that I can't do a lot with my neck yet. That's another thing I gotta update you on. I've already talked to y'all for 7 minutes. I'm sorry, it's been a few days. I gotta give y'all what's up. And I apologize, this is morning nose. I have this every morning. Anyway, the other amazing thing that, and the other reason why I wanna wait before I start engaging my neck in doing certain moves and exercises and stuff, because I've slowly but surely started to increase my abs, my ab work, and I'm starting to get back to where I can do 200, you know, crunches, which is what my original goal was, but I'm trying to be really careful with what exercises engage my neck, even if it's just a little bit, you know. I finally have gotten in to see a physical therapist, or I have a scheduled appointment for a physical therapist. So my first physical therapy appointment is this coming Tuesday. So, and it took a while for me to be able to get in because they were backlogged as far as appointments were concerned. So that's why it's taken me so long to finally get to physical therapy, that and of course my parents. So that kind of threw me off. I didn't even pay attention to even scheduling it, and then it wasn't until after all of that that I finally scheduled it. They were also backlogged and, you know, didn't have appointments for a while because it's really popular. So I was like, that's fine, I just want to be able to go to who I know is going to help me out, and he's been highly recommended. So I go to him on Tuesday. And the other and final last update I got to tell y'all, and I'll tell you guys about my macros here in a little bit, what macros I'm testing out to see how they work with my body. Which is why I love flexible eating, is so I'm gonna see the physical therapist. So I'll start physical therapy Tuesday, which is great because they're gonna show me what exercises I can do, what movements I can make to help strengthen that part of my neck, and stretches that'll help to prevent that thing from happening again. It's gonna happen again is a good possibility because I'm gonna always have this issue, but just ways to remedy it a little bit and make it so that it doesn't happen often. And then I got a massage finally, y'all. Y'all know how long my chiropractors and doctors and whoever the fuck have been telling me to do that. So I got a massage yesterday for the very first time in forever, okay? I get massages maybe once every year, once every other year. It's very rare. But I have to now consistently do it at least through the next few weeks. So, yeah, your girl signed up from one of those little massage places or whatever. So I'll be getting massages weekly for the next couple of weeks. Probably for the next 3 weeks, just to kind of loosen up my back, because when I got my massage, I got it yesterday. they didn't even have time, enough time to get through my whole body because that's how tight everything is because of my powerlifting and stuff. And then also because I try and, you know, this is tight because of that issue. So anyway, that's the update for everything going on right now, okay? Your girl is gonna be starting physical therapy. I've started my massage therapy. I'm gonna do a massage once a week. I don't know how often he's gonna have me come in to do physical therapy. I'll find out. This is my first appointment with him Tuesday. Really happy about that. A huge part of what I'm trying to do right now is just, I'm really trying to work on self. Not that I've not ever done that, because clearly you guys know I've been working out like crazy. But I've neglected certain things that I know I need to do, that I've been recommended to do, the massages, the physical therapy, those types of things. I have to start doing that shit, because if I don't want to be out of the gym for 3 weeks like last time, I need to make sure that I'm keeping up with everything. You know what I'm saying? So that's what's going on with your girl in a nutshell. I apologize for the early morning, long as hell update, but I wanted to give you guys an update on everything. The last and final thing is that I'm playing with my macros. I want to see where my body, because I'm plateauing. So I want, because you guys know I've been doing this for like 2 months, 2.5 months, almost three. And of course it's been altered. My macros have been altered. However, right now it's time for me to start. I want to just play around with a little bit. And now that I'm starting to kind of know and understand the whole system of counting macros, and kind of understanding and knowing how to adjust my macros accordingly, because I've just been doing research. And then of course I've been learning through Jessica and Yami and everyone that I've been using as resources. So I've been playing around with my macros. And so this week I'm experimenting with macros. Keep in mind it's loose this week. I'm not going to really get serious about it until Monday, so I have a full week on it, because I want to get started with physical therapy and massage and all that kind of shit. So let me see how long I've been. Golly, dang it to hell, I'm sorry. But yeah, so that's the deal. So macros right now, keep in mind we're going out tonight to eat and all that shit. And I've been counting everything, my drinks and all that shit. But keep in mind I won't get really hardcore about it, although it's been working these last few days. My macros right now, let's see, 180 carbs, it is 75 fat, and it is 120 protein, okay? And I'm just experimenting with it just to play around with it. I may up my protein and reduce my carbs. I might carb cycle as well on certain days that I'm not working out. I'm just experimenting with this set of macros to kind of see. I didn't reduce my carbs, but I did increase my fat. So we're gonna see how that goes. And I don't know, we're gonna see. So far I've been dropping since I started to, you know, since I changed my macros. So tonight doesn't really count, although I'm gonna put it in my Fitness Pal. You guys, a lot of you guys follow me on my Fitness Pal. Socialite Sandy on my Fitness Pal, if you guys are wondering. Hey honey bunny,
what's up?
Hi, how are you my dear?
Good.
You feeling good?
Yeah,
coming out feeling about 10 pounds lighter. Yeah. Is that how you feel? No.
Maybe not 10, but at least 2. What's up, y'all?
What's up? Hey, man, I told you, morning rituals, man, baby.
You got a little skill over here with this. I was walking right through this thing.
I'm sorry, babe.
I just need another cup of Joe right now.
He's obsessed, I'm telling you. Them cafe caramels. I'm about to have our, this has been my favorite go-to in the morning, man.
You sure what kind we normally get?
The yogurt?
Yeah, the caramel.
Oh my God, yeah. Lord. Yeah, that's the cafe caramel.
Yeah, do the hand.
You guys know we've been doing that forever. Oh, you want me to do the hand thing?
I don't think I see that.
In case you guys want to try it out. It's bomb. Yeah,
that's good stuff right there, y'all.
It's bomb. For any of you guys who don't
I can't live without it.
If you don't like the taste of coffee, like I'm not a big, I love coffee person, that's definitely a great option. Ooh, let me show you something. Ooh, I want to try, I might try this out to
instead.
I didn't think to do that.
The cold stuff, yeah.
Yes, okay.
I'll give it a shot.
So, I got this at the stove the other day. It's Starbucks vanilla latte. And it was just at Walmart in the milk section, okay?
Shake well.
And it's kind of one of those things that I was like, oh, you know what? If I'm heading to the gym and I need a little caffeine boost if I'm going in the morning or something like that, as opposed to bringing hot coffee, I can just put it on some ice and put a little cinnamon in it and keep it moving. Because you guys know, you know, Kiki got me on them soy vanilla lattes. This is not soy. This is just a vanilla latte. So let me know if you guys have tried this out. But it has 5 full Starbucks size tall, I think, servings in it.
Yeah, I'm trying a little bit of this and see how I like it.
Yeah, I kind of want to try it too. Because the soy vanilla lattes at Starbucks are fucking fire. You're a bartender now. You did it all slow. Anyway, this is what it looks like if you guys are in Wally World or Target or wherever they carry it. And anyway, I already have a hot cup of Joe. So maybe before I go to the gym, I might take this with me. This might be a good little quick something that I can take to the gym because it's espresso. Before I go, ooh shit, yeah, the carbs on it are a little high. Anyway, so we'll see.
But a quick shot of energy.
Yeah, before we head in, I might do half of a serving before we go in. But the other thing we've been doing is this. This has been phenomenal. I'm about to drop everything. The toasted coconut, toasted coconut vanilla. Greek yogurt, bitch. When I say this is so fucking fire, fire, fire. Fire. I kept seeing it on everyone's feeds, and then Yami talked about it, and I mean everybody done talked about this shit. Like, oh, that's your phone. That's the
Damn, what is this?
He took yours or it's mine, but it's Shopkick. Telling us what the deals are today, so let me know what the good deals are. Anyway, so I'm having that with my usual granola. Granola, you guys know, has tons of carbs. You know that. Tons. I mean, it's literally 38 grams of carbs per serving, which is only half a cup. But that's the reason why I eat it first thing in the morning. I typically don't eat this later on unless I need the carbs or whatever. And this is a great pre-workout. If you're going to the gym, great easy meal. So you just use one of these bad boys, put it in a bowl. Put this bad boy in a bowl. Okay. And what I do.
You're making the whole thing?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And I cut up 4 ounces of strawberries because you guys know I measure everything.
Let me eat some oatmeal in a little bit.
You're gonna eat oatmeal. Okay. Yeah. And then I do a little bit of honey. Keep in mind this is only if you have the carbs to do it. Okay? And I just happen to have the carbs. So yeah, my camera timed out. But yeah, so I'll use this, a little bit of this. I usually do a tablespoon of this. And then sometimes if I need the fiber, I'll put a serving size of the Benefiber in there, just so I'm getting my fiber for the day.
I'm gonna put some of this in my yogurt.
You gonna put that in your yogurt?
Yeah.
You were having oatmeal.
Well, I am, in a little bit.
Oh, okay, that's what I mean.
Yeah, we gotta watch these shows first.
Yeah, so we are watching, what is this, House of Cards?
We're watching House of Cards, okay? That's one show. And we started last night, but I, you know, of course, fell asleep. So I gotta start all over again.
I fell asleep too, but I got through more than he did.
So, we're watching House of Cards now. I'm watching
the new season. It's out on Netflix. If any of you guys haven't noticed,
I'm watching myself Arrow, which is a great show.
I gotta get caught up on
Daredevil, and you guys know, of course, I finished Jessica Jones. So
that shit had to go.
Jessica Jones, Daredevil, and Arrow.
Mm-hmm.
If I had to rank these three shows in order, I'm almost finished with Daredevil.
Okay,
I
had
like
two more episodes left. Which one was
left? So far, if I had to rank them, I would rank Arrow first, Daredevil, and then Jessica Jones.
Really? Yeah. Arrow? Is Arrow, that good?
That's a good show, yeah.
Arrow, so he swears I love Arrow. You really think I'm gonna like Arrow?
It's I'm on episode 8 or 9 right now on Arrow.
How many episodes?
I'm on episode 12 of Daredevil.
Well, can you wait for me? Can I get caught?
I ain't waiting on you. I told you 2 days ago to watch it, you didn't watch it.
No! You know,
I ain't waiting on you.
Y'all think, since I work from home, that I would watch television, but I don't watch any TV when I'm here. The only time I watch TV is when he gets here.
You better start watching something.
The TV doesn't get turned on.
I told you to watch it. It's a good show.
Look.
But, I'm watching those three. Then we got to add House of Cards to the mix.
Mm-hmm.
And what else is coming on?
House of Cards. There was something else.
Well, y'all know Game of Thrones. We're Game of Thrones fanatics.
Oh, that's coming.
That's coming next month. So we're trying to get these shows out the way to make room for Game of Thrones, all
right? Now that's coming in April, right?
April's
a great month, by the way.
I gotta go, y'all.
April is a fantabulous month. If you guys are not aware, the countdown has officially begun till my motherfucking birthday, bitches! Shit, y'all knew that shit was coming at some point. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm trying to see what Juice gonna do for my birth. You know what I mean? I'm trying to see what's going on and shit. I actually want to go out of town. I'm just ready to go on vacation. You guys know we asked y'all to give us suggestions. You guys gave us some great suggestions, and that's what we are actually going to be working on probably in the next week too, is to just schedule some kind of trip to get the fuck out of Dodge for some good sun and beaches or sand or something. We need it. It's been so long since we've had a real vacation. So That's what we're gonna do. We are working on that. So wish us luck. And we've been looking at your guys' suggestions. We still haven't gotten a mattress, by the way. This is the first time y'all saw us looking for mattresses. Is the last time we looked for mattresses. So we need to get back to that. But yeah, man. We are doing our Thiz-Night-E. Oh yeah, we gotta tell them what we're doing tonight. Huh?
Yeah, don't
like
we're gonna do that this weekend.
The mattress thing? Nah. Tonight we have some plans. I'll let Juice tell you the plans for tonight when he comes up here to do make his breakfast. And you're gonna be very surprised that we're actually going to do this because it involves someone that we actually just roasted in a previous vlog. However, we're willing to give people second chances. You know. We're willing to do that. Aren't we, Juice?
Oh, yeah.
We're willing to do that, right? We gotta give people, you know, our people chances every now and again, you know what I mean? So that's what we're hoping. Babe, where's the honey? Oh, Lord. Anyway, another thing I've been doing lately, or I'm starting to use, is Stevia. I know a lot of you guys get on my ass about Splenda. I still have Splenda. Keep that in mind. But my understanding is Stevia is a better option and a healthier one. So I'm just trying it out to see if I can get acclimated with the taste. You guys see what I'm saying? I'm trying to just experiment and do different things. Oh, I've got so many things to show y'all. Look, this is what happens when we take a few days off the vlog. There's a lot I gotta show y'all. Like, there's something I wanna show you that I got, and a couple things I got in the mail. I'll show you guys a little bit later. And then Juice will tell you guys what we are doing this evening on date night. And you'll see that in a minute. So let me go ahead and go take this honey back from my husband, okay? And Juice will be back with y'all in a minute. What up, y'all? Okay, so we're back. We're eating our next meal of the day. We haven't done anything, clearly, as you guys can see, outside of watching three episodes of
House of Cards. Yeah.
The three that he done missed yesterday that I stayed up to watch, even though I was kind of intermittently in and out because I was kind of falling asleep. So I was able to catch up on two. Still going to the gym, and we're getting ready to have our next meal. So we had, what did you have as your first meal, babe? Damn.
Just had some yogurt and honey.
Okay, so I had a yogurt granola.
Hey, we ought to be ashamed of ourselves, though, because it's such a nice day outside. We've
it's
been inside
degrees.
Watching TV.
I know, and that's terrible. So we are gonna get out today and go to the gym.
This day going.
I promise. Okay, so I'll go ahead and tell you what we're gonna do tonight, right? Or do you want to tell them? I'm nothing major.
Go ahead and tell them.
Tonight?
Yes. What's
wrong?
Might have broke
something. Oh, well. I even want to know. So, what are we doing, my love?
Tonight we are. Okay, here we go. Tonight we are. Well, first of all, we want to get some food. Of course, you know, we got to fill our bellies.
Yeah.
After a good workout. And after that, we are going to see Marlon Wayans in concert.
Yeah.
And when I say concert, I mean on his comedy tour.
Right.
One of the Wayans brothers finally come to St. Louis, and so we're going to go check them out.
Yep.
See what's up.
So I don't know if any of you guys are going.
Since we were so disappointed by 50 Shades of Black, or WAC, as she calls it, we're gonna go check them out tonight. Mm-hmm. And you know, hey, we love scary movies and all the stuff they've done. We
used to watch one of my favorite movies in the entire world.
Yeah, so we love all that stuff. So tonight we're gonna go check them out and see how it does in stand-up comedy. All right.
I have been waiting for them to come. Any of the Wayans brothers, mostly Marlon. They had a comedy. They had a time where it was the three of them, like Damon, Sean, and Marlon, on one comedy tour. And I was praying they came to St. Louis. They never came here. So I just randomly was on Instagram, and then Marlon was, he made some kind of joke about the Rams, talking about he coming this weekend. Like, it was very like, oh my God, what the? Like, I feel like I was meant to see that shit so that we could actually go and check him out. Because I've been waiting for them to actually have a tour date in St. Louis, but it's just him. So that should be interesting to see.
Yeah, I don't know what the other brothers are doing, but it'd be nice for everybody to come.
Yeah, that'd have been cool.
But at least we'll get a chance to check Marlon out.
Yeah.
And see what's up with him.
I don't know, his comedy is just not that funny to me. But, you know, based on, you know what I'm saying? I don't know. know. We gonna see. We gonna see. But that's what we're gonna go to and check out tonight. So I don't know if any of y'all went, because by the time you guys see this, it's gonna be past tense. So maybe we'll run into a couple Fam Bam members. Oh yeah, yeah. Maybe we might run into a couple of y'all out there to watch it. It's at a new comedy club that we've never been to. So that's gonna be a new thing to check out. And then where are we going to eat?
We're gonna get some bone. That bone. Man, what's the place called?
Bonefish.
Bonefish Grill, y'all. Bonefish Grill.
Bone.
Gonna get some bang bang shrimp tonight.
Woo! Why am I so excited though?
I don't know what. Ah.
Oh really?
It's burning off here. Yeah.
No. Anyway, we're gonna go and get some Bonefish Grill. So.
Bonefish Grill, some bang bang shrimp.
Bang bang tacos. Pretty much everything we're gonna eat is gonna be bang bang.
Yeah, because it's right by the place where we're going tonight to see the comedy show. So we figure we might as well go eat next door or down the street. And that way we can not be late.
Yeah, well, that's the intent. And then by the time
saw. You can't be saying that's the intent.
I'm just saying.
That's what we're doing.
But by the time I saw that. And the tickets were available for purchase. All the reserved seats are the ones that you could have like picked out or selected, a little more expensive or whatever, but still could have had a reserved seat. They were sold out. So we're kind of in the open seating, which that's great and all, but that means we're gonna have to get there a little bit earlier, hopefully, so we can get a decent seat, because I really don't know how this place is set up. But the one thing I don't want is for us to be in the way back. You know what I'm saying? If we don't have to. I mean, it's not the end of the world. We'll see him. We'll be able to hear him. It's no big deal. But ideally, we'd like to be middle to, you know, middle to front if that's possible. So we're hoping going to someplace to eat right there, right there, early enough, right, would get us there early enough to be able to at least go and check and make sure that tickets are there and they're cool and that we can get some decent seats. They also added another time for him to come on stage at 11, because I guess it sold out so fast.
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
Mm-hmm.
That means
he ain't gonna be that long on stage, right?
Well, I think one of the shows is at 9, and then the first show is, I think, at 7, the next one, I think, is at 9, and then the one after that is at, like, 11. You know what I mean? So it's probably giving him, like, a little bit of a break in between. He's probably going to do an hour set, I would assume.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, you got to have a guy coming out, you know, as a beforehand.
Oh, yeah, like a fluffer.
Introduce him, so he's going to tell some jokes.
Well, that's what we hope. So maybe there'll be a fluffer, and that'd be kind of cool. So, and then we're still trying to decide. We might buy them today. We're going to see before we go to the gym. I'll let you guys know for sure. But there's another comedy. You guys know I love comedy shows. I don't know if I've told you all that. You guys haven't seen us go to many, because not everyone really comes here. You know, not all the time. And some do come, but it's like you don't hear about it until it's gone already. So anyway, Cedric, which is another one of my favorite comedians. He is from St. Louis, as you guys may or may not know, right?
Mm-hmm.
He is going to be coming here with D.L. Hughley, which I don't think he's funny at all.
Come on.
He kind of like.
Yeah, one comedy special that was hilarious.
That's horrible. He's not my type of comedian, but I'll give him a chance, you know, if we get the tickets. So Cedric, D.L., I forgot the other guy's name. And then Eddie Murphy's brother.
Eddie Murphy's brother.
I forgot his name though. You know what I mean? I don't remember.
Charlie Murphy.
What's that? That nigga was what's the dude that was on? Malcolm Jamal Warner's. He was with Griffin. Eddie Griffin.
Yeah.
He's gonna be there. So there's like two, and there's two more comedians. I can't remember who they were. I think it's one or two more comedians. Anyway, they're coming to Scott Train.
My brother just saw old boy in Texas.
Who?
He's gonna be in the next barbershop movie. Comedian, the guy, I forgot his name, but he said he was hilarious.
Really?
The guy that's coming, he's gonna be in a barbershop movie coming out next month.
I don't know which one. I mean, there's so many people.
What's his name? Here it is. I'm looking at this.
Yeah. But yeah, so I want to go. Only thing
y'all know who I'm talking about. It's the guy who's gonna be in barbershop.
There's tons of people in barbershop.
The comedian in barbershop. Who you said you thought might have wrote this movie?
Which movie?
Barbershop.
Oh my boy!
Yeah.
Oh my God, Black. Something isn't it? Is that his last name? Black. When I remember his name, I will tell you, because he is one of the funniest comedians I have seen, and he's kind of a newer comedian.
Yeah.
Not newer, but like, he's not Kevin, not Kevin Hart, because Kevin Hart's just, like, not overexposed, he's just everywhere. Does that make sense? Y'all know I love Kevin Hart, I have a special place in my heart for Kevin. But he is fucking hilarious. If I can remember his name, I'll remember. Oh my God, really? See, I gotta look to see if he'll, if he comes here, I will be there with bells on.
He said he was hilarious.
Oh, no, he is fucking hilarious. Every time I see his stand-up, I die laughing, it's hilarious. But I can't remember his name. He was a writer on a show too. But yeah, if you guys remember who it is, it's gonna be in the new Barbershop. He's always talking, what's that thing he always says? Balls deep. If you guys have ever seen him do a stand-up, you'll know exactly who the fuck that is. Yeah, it's him, for sure. Okay. He's fucking hilarious. Anyway, if he ever came here, I'd be there with bells on. Anyway, so we're deciding on whether we're going to get, like, nosebleed seats or try to get decent seats at the comedy show next Saturday. I think it'd be kind of cool to go do something a little different. You guys know I love different, and now that it's kind of sort of officially spring, although we are still getting colder weather, but it's nice out today.
It's spring in 2 weeks, I think.
I know. Spring has almost officially sprung, and this is when, you know, we get back out again and try new things and go try new restaurants and sit outside and, you know what I mean, enjoy weather and shit. So, yeah. So I'll let you guys know if we end up going to that. And if you guys are going, I'll let you girl, you know, because by the time this video comes out, it wouldn't have been, it would still be a few more days before that Scott Trade Center comedy show thing. Yeah, we'll let you guys know about
it. In the meantime, we got some bacon and turkey sauce.
Yes,
going.
We got some shit going.
Got some eggs over here that's about to go in next.
We got some of that right there.
We got oatmeal.
We look like we eat like a whole hell of a lot, but
I need some carbs for the gym.
Yes, so we got to fuel up. I've already put together today's workout. Today is going to be about the glutes, and I think I'm going to go ahead and incorporate abs.
Yeah.
Yep. What are you doing?
Our girl Jess is out in Chicago right now getting some knowledge for us. Mm-hmm. She has some kind of convention where she learns some more about this all kind of shit.
So, workout stuff, fitness shit. Yeah, she likes getting new certifications and stuff.
We'll see if she can share some of that knowledge with us.
Mm-hmm, because she's going to be creating that little workout for us to do for the next couple weeks. Which would be nice because it'll get us focused. Because you guys, I don't know if you guys noticed in the videos, Juice does a lot of the same exercises. I try to vary my shit up because I get bored. Y'all know Aries all day. But he does a lot of the same movements.
You tape a lot of the same movements.
Nah, motherfucker. You do the same movements. Every time we go to the damn gym, you be doing the same shit.
That's not true. That's not true. Don't believe the hype.
I have massage, so I need to just warm up my muscles a little bit. But yeah, look. Don't let him fool you, okay? So she's gonna give us two completely different workout plans, which would be cool. I'm excited. We have to go get some more supplements, babe. We ran out of, which one, CLA or for L-carnitine?
Both.
Okay, well, no, we're running low on one of them for sure. Anyway, we gotta go and pick up some supplements, and then maybe, can we go today? So we don't have to rush out?
Yeah, do whatever you want.
He's only saying that because the camera's off.
Okay, good.
Yeah, I can go get some more. Good. L-carnitine, CLA, and then I think we're running low on BCAAs. Branched chain amino acids. Anyway, so yeah, y'all. I guess we're going to let you go. We're going to go ahead and eat. I'm going to go ahead and get my bagel. I'm going to get some good carbs, good protein in me and shit. And then maybe tomorrow, I'll show you guys the stuff that I purchased because I know today's going to probably be a longer vlog since we're going to be going out tonight. So I'll spare y'all showing y'all that stuff, and I'll show you in tomorrow's vlog because it's stuff that you'll probably want to get your hands on. It's kind of cool, you know what I mean? And I have some more stuff I'm going to open up, so we'll see. Anyway, all right, y'all. I guess we will see y'all at the gym.
Yeah. We'll be right back.
1. This workout is killer. Why, you ask? Because your girl is supersetting everything. So every exercise you're seeing me do, I'm doing 2 exercises at a time. So for every 2 exercises, just know those 2 exercises are done back to back with no rest in between. So it's like a very long, high interval training session and a high intensity interval training session. By the way, if you guys haven't seen my new video, I got a new video that I just put up that gives you guys a really great 15 minute cardio session, cardio workout. It's a HIIT cardio workout. Just so you guys get an idea of exactly what I mean when I say HIIT, I will link it down below so you guys can check it out. It's on the other channel, The Socialite Life, if you haven't checked it out. I'll link it down below if I remember. Try it, I promise y'all. You're gonna burn a shit ton of calories in a very short period of time. The other great thing about it is HIIT training or HIIT cardio is a great way to burn fat faster. And it's also a faster amount of time. You get the workout done and over with, but it's very high intensity, hence the name. So I show you an entire workout. It's only 15 minutes. You gotta go balls to the wall. There's rest in between and all of that good stuff. So I'll leave a link down below if you haven't checked it out. Check it out though, y'all, and try it. I promise y'all, you'll love it. But everything I'm doing today, because we got here super late, I'm doing back to back. So I can try to get as much of it done as possible and get a great cardio burn. At least burn what I've already eaten for most of today, because I know I'm not gonna eat really good tonight. And then we're gonna be a little tiny bit late for dinner. I have to change the reservation, let's put it that way. But hopefully we'll make it in time for Marlon. We might get nosebleed because we're gonna be there late. But anyway, we're gonna be there, it's all good. And the biggest thing is I wanna make sure that we got our workout in. Juice is way over there. I'll show some of his workout too, but I just wanted to holler at y'all. Let y'all know we made it to the gym finally after we watched all them episodes of, what you call it, whatever that show is called, Netflix, look, I'm dying. House of Cards. Look at this, I mean literally nasty. And before I did all that you're seeing or that you're gonna see, the girl was on the Stairmaster too, and I haven't done the Stairmaster in 2 weeks. I've done cardio, I just haven't done the Stairmaster. And that's one thing for me I have to keep up with, because if I stop doing it for a couple weeks, I completely almost have to start back from scratch as far as my endurance on the shit. So I did 20 minutes on the Stairmaster, but I really forced myself to do that 21 minutes to be exact, and I just gotta make sure I do it at least once a week so I can get back to the endurance level I had when I was doing it every week. So we're gonna be doing a lot of experimenting over these next couple weeks. But I'll take you all along with me, show you guys workouts and shit. Let you know when I change my macros and stuff like that. I know not everyone tells their subscribers or their, you know, followers or whoever. Of course, y'all are fam bam, so I don't even like saying it like that. But you know what I'm saying. A lot of people don't really like sharing their macros. I don't mind it. You guys know that's specific to me, okay? I eat a lot of calories. I eat a lot of food. Just so you know, and I am not small. Okay? I don't know what the camera makes me look like, in case any of y'all are thinking, oh, she's... Nah, bitch. This bitch right here is... I'm a thick-ass motherfucker. Just don't get it twisted. Anyway, and I eat a lot. So, don't base any macros, my macros, on you. Don't use my macros. Because there's... I mean, you'll gain. If it's not based on your weight, your height, etc., etc. You see what I'm saying? So, anyway. Y'all already know not to do that, right? But I just want to give you guys a heads up, and of course, make sure you check with the doctor, or whoever, you know, medical, to make sure that you can do any of this type of shit, right? Right, okay. Anyway, all right, let me get back to this. What's up, y'all? Okay, not only were we brushing our asses to get ready to come all the way the hell out here, which I'm trying to find, I don't know where Juice is. However, we did make it to the Loom, which is a brand new damn comedy club in the Loom. Y'all, didn't even know it existed. It's actually at the Galleria, if you can believe it. Y'all know I've been to the Galleria a couple of times. I just haven't been on this side of the Galleria. Looks like it looks brand new. Like, there's some areas that probably need a little bit of work. But, like, it's a functioning comedy club / restaurant / bar. Look at all this shit. I'm probably gonna get shut down in here because I've got a camera and they're gonna think that my ass is gonna like tape this comedy show, and I'm really not trying to do that, you know what I'm saying? Although I would do that for y'all, you know. So anyway, let me see. Make sure I'm not missing any calls from Juice. He's parking the car right now because basically here's what happened. We were supposed to go to Bonefish Grill first. Go have something to eat, chillax, have a drinky poo, take our time and shit. Our black asses got to the gym way too damn late. Then we had to rush home, take a shower, get dressed, you know what I'm saying? Get ready, you know what I mean? Figure out what the fuck to wear. I already knew what I was gonna wear, but he had to figure out what he was gonna wear, you know what I'm saying? And iron a shit, yada, 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 yada. Long story short, we decided to go ahead and come here so we could be here early because, number one, we got open seating. We didn't get the reserve because I didn't know about it until after reserve had been sold out. So, yeah, I'll show you guys the lay of the land if I can. I'm trying to be a little bit discreet. Here he comes. Okay, I just want to make sure because I have the tickets in hand. You know, I didn't want them to get in trouble at the door, but for a minute they couldn't even find my tickets. So I was like, hold up now. But they found them. It's all good. We got it. So, yeah, we're going to see how this goes. They even added another show tonight, which I think I might have told y'all. Hey, Juice. Okay. It actually sold out, so I'm glad we got here. So it is now 8:20, and it starts at 9:15. You know what I'm saying? So I think we made a good choice coming here first. We chose to opt out of Bonefish, at least for right now. But more than likely, because I don't really plan on eating here, like maybe we'll get like an appetizer. I actually want to go eat at Bonefish. So
if she said they got food here.
They're gonna be a while. They're talking about it's backed up.
Food is.
I think they just opened up the restaurant part of this place. So yeah. Give you guys lay of the land, see
so where's the show gonna be?
Say hi, Juice.
What up? Hey, finally early we come.
I know, right? We aren't early for the reservations for dinner, but we're early for here.
So thankfully. Where's the show gonna be?
So basically, yeah. Basically it's down there.
Okay.
Do is basically line up according to what's the letter that's on the back of our ticket, and ours is letter B. So they're gonna call each section by letter. So there's an A and there's a B. I don't know if there's a C or not. And then we just kind of go wherever we can find it.
Check it out. Check it out.
Oh my gosh.
That Aries Spear is coming next weekend. It'd be good to see.
Oh, that might be a good one.
I'm check him
check
out.
It out.
I got Aries Spears coming.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't heard of the rest of these guys, but I might have to go check
they
that out.
They got some good people coming.
Yeah. All right.
And y'all know I was talking about going to the other one that's at Scotch. Shit, I might just fuck around and buy the Aries Spears tickets and just call it a wrap. This is like, I mean, there's food, there's drink. We know where it is now. And if the spot's cool when we walk in or when we get in, this might be the jump off. So yeah, oh my God, what's that one place? The other one that's out in Westport. What's that one place?
The Funny Bone.
Yeah. This might give the Funny Bone an issue because really the Funny Bone is like the only for real comedy place in Beloit, established comedy place.
Yeah.
But this is cool. Like, I am so surprised that it's here because I didn't know. I don't even know how long it's been open. So yeah, we haven't had a server to the first yet, and they're already starting to line up, which is making me anxious because you guys know I'm all about being comfortable. So like part of me kind of wants to stand in line.
No, she said you can order food during the show.
Oh shit. I almost want to just have something light while we're watching and just go to Bonefish. Because you know, they're it's gonna be far food. I'd rather go to Bonefish, to be honest. Maybe have some kind of appetizer while we're sitting here and then just go to Bonefish afterwards if they're still open. We could always go to.
I'll be showing a fight here tonight.
Okay. Yeah, and if not, we can always go to Cheesecake Factory. Because it's in here, and Cheesecake closes late. So we could always go there too, right afterwards. It's in the same building, which is nice. This might be the new jump off, y'all. We're gonna see how Marlon Wayans does. We're gonna hope he proves us wrong, because you know, 50 Shades of Wax is trash. So, anyway, great workout. Oh my gosh, great workout. I feel amazing. Oh, I'm gonna have to show y'all my little outfit or something. Here's what I'm hoping I can do. When I get back home, because I didn't have time, because we're rushing to get out here, I'm hoping that I can shoot a fashion board Friday. Because y'all need to see the little outfit I'm rocking. It's just sexy, it's everything, okay? And you guys see I'm rocking a nude lip. This is Juice's favorite. He prefers nude lips on me, so we did neutral colors and natural tones and all of that shit today, so. Anyway, see, that makes me anxious that they're like sitting in line. Because I don't want to be nosebleed. Is that weird? I wish I'd gotten the reserve. Anyway, all right.
Enough talking. I'm gonna look up this these Aerie Spears tickets. And yeah, we'll let you guys know how this goes. I may not be able to turn the camera on when we get inside, if I can. If I do, it's gonna be quick. Because I don't want them to think I'm gonna take Marlon Wayans, and I don't want my camera to get confiscated, so I'll try my damnedest. If not, you might just see us on the flip side when he's done. We'll let you know how it is though, alright? What's up, y'all? So, we are done, finally, after 11 o'clock, y'all, with, what time is it now? What's the real time?
11:53.
Oh my God, it's midnight. Anyway, we literally, legitimately just got out of Marlon Wayans, the whole set, okay? And yeah, y'all, we're at Cheesecake Factory at the Galleria. They close here, I think, at 12:30.
Yeah,
so we just made it like under the buzzer. Y'all know, well, y'all don't know this, but when we left y'all last, y'all know we haven't had dinner yet. So we legit just watched Marlon's set with no food in our stomachs at all, except for the little food
artichoke dip.
We'll talk about that in a second. So, yeah, what did you think, babe? I'm gonna get your impression first.
Hey, he made up for that 50 Shades of Grey shit.
Yeah,
that shit was funny.
That was funny as hell.
Not the movie, but the stand-up show was funny.
Yeah, that shit was funny.
He made up
for
that shit.
Yeah, that shit was funny.
He made up.
Like, we for real were like cracking the fuck up. Oh,
good. How's it going?
Hold on, I'm right back. Okay, my bad, y'all. Let me let it focus. Let me let it focus. Okay. Sorry for lighting. Like I said, we're at Cheesecake Factory, if I didn't mention it earlier. It is after midnight at this point. They're going to close at 12:30, so we barely made the mark. And it's, of course, dimly lit and barely anybody in here, except somebody has their infant up in this bitch. It's like literally midnight. Can you hear that? Yeah, there's an infant in here. Anyway, so we're literally ordering a full-on, not spread, but we're eating full-on meals at this point because we have not eaten outside of a little appetizer we got when we first got in to the room. And hopefully I was able to get good enough footage of what the room looked like where he came out, so that way you guys can get a visual of what
the Helium Comedy
Man, listen, my ass, we could have easily been kicked out that bitch. I tried to sneak so much damn video. Juice tried to sneak some video. You guys shut down and shit. We did shoot, I think you got some good footage of
the room,
and it's a big size room.
Yeah, nice size.
Mm-hmm. Where they had Marlon. Anyway, I'm gonna let Juice finish what he was saying. You like, what was your favorite part? Well, you don't want to say like his jokes, but
the stand-up was funny. I mean, he did a good job with this. This is what was missing from the movie.
Yeah.
I guess he had to do what he had to do for the movie, but the stand-up was. Yeah, he did a good job on the stand-up.
Yeah, he's a complete nutter goofball.
He made up for that shit.
Yeah, dirty as hell. Like, his ass is dirty as fuck, and it was perfect. It was hilarious, okay? Oh, by the way, before I even forget, because I don't want to forget their names, I saw a couple fan band members in there. We actually met Malibu and Trinae. So, and I believe Trinae's husband or boyfriend was with her. So, hey, y'all. Thank you for coming over to say what's up. I think Malibu was in our in the 9 o'clock show that didn't start till after 10. Okay. And Trinae was going into the 11 o'clock show that they added because he sold out of the first two like that. He actually has a show tomorrow too. That one, I think, sold out also. He's got one tomorrow, just one.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Marlon, I mean, he was hustling, let me tell you, okay? Juice tried to get video of him while he was trying to take pictures of people who were trying to sneak that shit. But you know, this camera isn't really discreet. And even with the iPhones, the phone he's got, or whatever, they would have caught it. Everybody was looking for cameras, for show. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
You guys need some
y'all
bread.
Caught it. No, we're good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Y'all know, whenever I come here, I have my chocolate martini. And it's got the, I've never had it with chocolate like this before. So we're going to see how
good.
That, yeah. And then, of course, he's got his usual.
Vodka tea, baby.
Yeah, vodka tonic. But yeah, okay, so my opinions of tonight, he was hilarious. Like, that's the kind of humor I'm talking about. Like, 50 Shades of Whack was just what it was. Like, it just...
He's making up.
He was fucking hilarious.
He's going around the country making up for that right now.
For real?
He's making his rounds, making up for that movie right now.
He even made a joke about making bad movies. And it's not to say that all his movies he's made or been in are bad, because we like, I mean, I love White Chicks. Love White
Chicks. Scary movies
were
good.
Yeah, scary movies were good. It's just this one in particular, like, I was just kind of like, y'all already know the deal. We done talked about it before. It just wasn't our thing at all. At all. But tonight, he was funny. You know, and he's crass and he's disturbing and he's dirty. Like, he's got that just, it's dirty humor. And then, you know, he was making fun of himself, and then his, of course, his brothers. And then his niece is actually who opened. We were wondering if he was gonna have a fluffer. Remember, we talked about that earlier. So his niece, what was her name again? Damn it. She's a Wayans, though. Damn it. Hold on. Y'all know I follow him on Instagram. Hold on, I'm about to find out. I'm about to see. Shantae Wayans. That is her name, Shantae. Anyway, she opened for him, and she was funny as all get out too. So I did get a chance to meet him. We both got a chance to meet him. You had to basically buy a t-shirt to be able to meet his ass. So it was pretty much like, you buy your photo, and then what they're gonna do is put the photo, which Lord knows what the fuck I look like in the photo that I took with him. They gonna put that photo on his Facebook, which they claim it's gonna be tonight. Highly doubt it. There was so much going on tonight. Like, the wait staff at this place.
Three people quit.
Yeah, three people quit in the first 7 o'clock show. So there was literally three people that had that entire room to get drinks and food for.
You talking about over 100 people.
Dude, 100. And a bunch of black folk too. Y'all know they weren't having it. We weren't trying to sit there waiting on our food. You know what I'm saying? So those poor waitresses were just running and gunning, okay? And then, how long would you say we stayed waiting to get into the show?
At the very least an hour,
right?
Yeah.
Because the show was officially supposed to start at 9:15. Y'all know, something told me, we better just go and see if we can go pick up our tickets and go early and skip Bonefish, because we clearly didn't go. I know, and we were like craving it and excited about it, so we'll just go the next time. However, we got there, what time would you say, about 8 o'clock? About 8:05?
8:15?
Yeah. And we got there, and it was clear as day, no problem, no one was around. We were one of the, you know, not one of the first, because there was a lot of people downstairs. Clearly, you guys saw that when we got here, got there. But we thought, oh, we cool, we're straight, we got our ticket. They did have it was organized. The problem is, they didn't have enough wait staff. Everything was all fucked up, people quit, yada yada. Long story short, we were standing in line for a good hour before we could even get in to go get seated. Once you got seated though, they had a specific spot for you to sit. It was organized, it was nice. Juice and I had great seats. Clearly from what you guys could see of what he shot, that's where we were sitting. So it was cool. Like, this Helium Comedy Club, once they get their shit together and they got some, you know, yeah, once they get that Similac off their breath, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna be a cool little spot. I mean, and there's only one other real comedy spot here in the Lou, the Funny Bone. And the Funny Bone, if Helium gets their shit together, especially because they're midtown and there's just a nicer spot, there's food and drink, they might shut Funny Bone down or give them a run for their money for real. Nah, because Funny Bone is gross, it's dirty, it's kind of like, yeah, it's smaller. You know, keep in mind, Marlon and a whole bunch of people, Marlon especially, Marlon, none of the Wayans, they've been on tour and never came here. You ought to wonder why that is. Because they really aren't a lot of venues for comedy out here. You either go to Scott Trade, which is what I was telling you about earlier, or you go to the Funny Bone, which I don't even think is a big enough venue to handle that.
No, it's not.
He'd have to have like 8 shows to make up for the number of people that were in this one. But anyway, all in all, it was a good experience.
And a 2-drink minimum, too.
Oh, yeah, just know you're going to have a 2-drink minimum.
They really didn't give us 1 drink.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Well, yeah, they wouldn't have been able to handle 2.
No.
It took almost an hour into the set before we got our food. Oh, and the artichoke dip was terrible. So don't order artichoke dip there at all. Like, avoid that shit. The chicken fingers were good, though. That wasn't good. The chicken fingers I saw everyone eating, though, that looked good. The dude next to me was having that.
That was terrible, too.
Yeah, if it was cold. Because they were just backlogged. Motherfuckers were getting their drinks for free at tables before we even got into the place. Because they were so backed up at the bar. So they just have a lot of stuff to work through. And the waitress told us as we were leaving, as we were checking out, that 3 people quit. So yeah, it was crazy. Marlon seemed frazzled as hell. You know what I'm saying? Didn't he seem frazzled? He was just like, I'm trying to get this money. That's it. You know, like, he wasn't trying to talk to nobody. He wasn't trying to say hi to nobody. He wasn't trying to fuck with nobody. He was like, look, you pay for these pictures and that's it. We gonna cheat. And I'm gonna put you on my Facebook so that, you know what I'm saying, people are directed to his Facebook. I mean, it's a smart move from a social media perspective. You know what I'm saying? Because he's all about social media, if you follow him, you know what I'm talking about. But all in all, it was a great show. Like, this was a great, and thank God we got there early, y'all. Otherwise, boy, we would have been in the nose. And there's no nosebleeds, by the way. Every seat went there was pretty good, except, oh my God, did you pick up? There was a whole group of white folk, and I'm saying that not because I'm trying to be racist, because he made a lot of jokes about Caucasians. And us, and everybody else. Just everybody, okay? He done hit everybody, okay? That whole side of the room didn't laugh not once. Like, very, very little. I mean, did you notice that on the right?
I wasn't looking.
Oh, your back was kind of shit. Oh my God. Like, I don't know if they expected that kind of humor. You know what I'm saying? I don't think they were ready for that. It was like a group of like 10 people. And they were not feeling that humor at all. Like, they were quiet as cats. Like, just, I'm talking about quiet. No smirk, no clapping. When he was getting offset, they weren't even like, because people were giving him standing ovations and blah blah. They weren't fucking whatever. Uh-uh. Oh, I did because I mean we were sitting in a mixed little group of people and they were clowning, having a good time. But that group over on the side of us was not. So anyway, it was good though. It was good. It was just interesting to see people's reactions.
It was funny.
Because he was crass. So what did you expect? It's Marlon Wayans, you know?
Good time.
Yeah. So it was cool. It was cool.
He damn sure made up for that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We were cracking up for real. Like, there was shit he would say. We're like, oh shit, okay. Like, it was good. But yeah. So there's a couple other people on the horizon that are coming to that particular comedy club. It's a nice comedy club, y'all. Like, I was very impressed.
Mm-hmm.
So we went ahead and got tickets for the next comedy show there already.
Aries Spears.
So we remember we showed you guys earlier that he was gonna be coming. We decided to go ahead as this focuses. Look at this. It's not liking the light in here. I apologize. Whoa, that's too much. Anyway, yeah. There we go. Hi. No, we decided to go to Aries Spears. So if any of y'all are going to Aries Spears at Helium Comedy Club, Hosh Girl down below. Because by the time you guys see this video, the tickets will still be out probably.
He'll be here in 2 weeks.
Yeah, he's literally going to be here in 2 Saturdays from now. So, and this time we got reserved seats. We got regular, you know, which is no big deal. We actually got great seats tonight. But if you have a chance to get reserved because you'll be first seated.
And you'll be waiting in the room over there.
Yeah, you can be actually sit and have some drinks. Yeah. So yeah, man.
Yeah.
Did you like your date night? Was it good?
Yeah, yeah.
It was cool.
Yeah,
no, we're about to partake.
Yeah. So yeah. That's pretty good.
Try it out.
It's good.
No, I told you. It's really good.
It's
just a chocolate martini.
Not bad. Not bad.
Has a little chocolate stuff on top, you know. And delicious. Okay.
All right.
Anyway, we're gonna go ahead and wait on our food. I got pasta carbonara. I know it's 12 midnight, but we're hungry. And then, what did you get, babe? What'd you get?
Hey. What?
What's wrong?
ABS got him.
What? What are you talking about? UFC?
Yeah, UFC fight, yeah.
Oh yeah, there was a UFC fight tonight that we missed. Did we mention that? I don't know if we did.
But I called the winner.
Yeah, he did call the winner. Holly Holmes, who beat Ronda Rousey not too long ago, right? In a huge upset. She actually fought the girl that Ronda Rousey, a girl that Ronda Rousey fought, and she lost. And she was like waiting for this opportunity. Like literally when Ronda Rousey lost, she was ready to pounce.
This is what I put right there.
Would you
home?
He said home was well, I don't want you to put all their information.
It's their nicknames.
Oh, okay. We'll do it right there.
See, put that was about
there it goes, home.
About 9 o'clock.
It's gonna knock her out. Oh, whoop. I see his comments. Anyway. So yeah, Juice actually called that she was gonna win. What's her name again? I forgot her damn daggone name. What's her name? Not Holly Holmes.
Misha Tate beat Holly Holmes, yeah.
Any of y'all watch that UFC. She lost to Ronda Rousey.
I gotta watch
so she was waiting for somebody to beat Ronda Rousey.
and now she fought Holly Holm. So if we weren't doing this tonight, we would have watched that fight for sure. So Tone and V have been keeping him up to date on what's going on. So we now know that Holly Holm lost and just called it. So anyway, hopefully I can get my picture off of Marlon's Facebook page or wherever he's got it. And hopefully it's decent, because if it ain't shit, I ain't putting that shit nowhere. I mean, y'all might see that shit, and that bitch ain't like, because they were rushing through those damn pics. Like, he was literally like, fuck it, give me my money. He wasn't worried about talking to nobody. Plus, he had another show afterwards, and they were super behind. His show was supposed to start at 9, and he didn't get on, like, they didn't start everything. Or 9:15. It was supposed to start at 9:15. It didn't start till after 10. And then people were sitting in line for damn near 2 hours. Oh my God. Juice, that's a long time that we sat in line then.
Oh, no.
My God, we were in line from 8:20-ish or so till about when they sat us, which was about 9:45. I mean, it was a long time. So that's the one thing. Get reserved if you go to the Healing Club until they get this shit together. Anyway, that was our review. So anyway, we're gonna eat, and I guess we'll see y'all on the flip side.